So good afternoon again, everyone. Welcome to ADL Learning Exchange Day 2. So we will be starting our first session now. So I'm Nina, an intern from the Ateneo Salt Institute. So for our first speaker, we have Joanna Minestabon to discuss creating interactive sites as a step, asynchronous learning activities through interactive sites. So Ms. Tabon is a grade school educational technology and student council moderator from Sacred Heart School Ateneo de Cebu. So let's give her a warm welcome.
Thank you so much, Ms. Nina. So, matches afternoon, everyone. Please allow me to share my screen with you. Okay, here. I don't know if you can all see the screen. Am I sharing already?
Yes, ma'am, we can see the screen.
Okay, thank you so much. So, matches afternoon, fellow Ignatian Formators, thank you for giving me this opportunity to share my online teaching experiences and insights in ADL Learning Exchange 2021. So, the title of my sharing is Asynchronous Learning Activities Through Interactive Sites. So, last school year, I realized that as a teacher, I can actually still do other learning activities other than giving my students a lecture, even if the platform was online. And it is through these online activities, like we have here the gallery walks, we have virtual exhibits, and we have film fests, among others, that can be done asynchronously by our students. So perhaps so that we will know if they really learned something from their asynchronous learning activity through these activities that you can see on the screen. So we need to have this evidence of learning. So I will be sharing some of my works that I did last year and some that I have prepared during the summer in-service program for this school year. So these async activities that we are talking about, these can be done through SharePoint and Google Sites. So here are some of my some of the sites that I did last school year. So we have the Ignatian Prayer Warriors SharePoint site for grade 3. This was from last school year. And then I tried to improve it for this school year, and I made a page for this SharePoint site. It's called Performance Task 1.2. We have the Bible Stories Virtual Gallery page. So this is a page from my Ignatian Prayer Warriors. We have here SharePoint site. Okay, I will also tell you later why it's called Ignatian Prayer Warriors. So this page here on the screen, this is an interdisciplinary activity that the kids will do in collaboration with the reading subject. So this is also the fruit of the horizontal articulation that we did during the summer in-service program for this school year. And then another page for this SharePoint site of the Ignatian Prayer Warriors, we have here the Holy Eucharist exhibit. So why is it called Ignatian Prayer Warriors for this SharePoint site? It's because I am a CLF teacher for grade 3. All of the most if not all, okay, of the lessons in grade 3, they talk about prayer and the Holy Eucharist. So for this batch, for this grade level, I actually have the goal of forming these young people, young men and women, to be prayer warriors. So that's why, this is why I called the SharePoint site Ignatian Prayer Warriors. So this is these are some examples for SharePoint. And then for Google, so we have here the Matches Society Student Council Google site. So I will show you the features later on. And then lastly, for Google site also, we have here the Human Bingo activity. So we have, I think everybody knows how to do the Human Bingo with our students, right? So this is usually a GTKY activity. sometimes administered by the guidance. So before the pandemic, so we have this human bingo activity wherein students would go around and they would ask their classmates questions so that they could write the names of their classmates inside the bingo card. So for example, in the card, it says there has a favorite color that is blue. So they're going to ask their classmates, you're going to roam around, they're going to ask their classmates, is your favorite color blue or are you the eldest in the family? So this is an activity wherein they can get to know each other. So this is made possible through the Google site. But you can also do this in SharePoint. So in here, I'll be showing you the features of the site. So let's begin with the Ignatian Prayer Warriors SharePoint site. So this is the homepage. I'm planning to post the faces of my kids for this school year. But since I haven't met them yet, so I just posted a picture that says, "Be a Prayer Warrior." So this is the homepage and the performance task 1.2 page that I designed for this school year in collaboration with a reading teacher is this one. We have here the Bible Stories Virtual Gallery page. And the general instruction says, learn about the Bible stories in this gallery by playing the videos or clicking on the play button of the videos. And then choose one Bible story that you like to write about. If you are ready to write, click on your gradient section and type your own version of your chosen Bible story. And then make sure to include the moral of the Bible story. So this is like a film fest for the kids. So there are two columns. So we have here stories from the Old Testament and then stories from the New Testament. So this is not all the stories in the Bible, but these are just selected stories. So we have here stories from the Bible. And at the end, we have another reminder of the name of the site. So it becomes interdisciplinary already. So we have interdisciplinary performance task 1.2. And the description says, did you learn something about God in the Bible stories? And it further says, I'm pretty sure you already have a favorite. Your task for today is to recall a favorite Bible story and narrate it by writing down its beginning, middle, and end. And then this is in collaboration with a reading teacher. Her lesson is on the elements of a story. So for grade 3. So for her lesson, it focuses on the beginning, middle, and end. And so the kids are going to write their own Bible story, their own version of the Bible story that they've read, but only one. If they are going to click on their grade and section, so for example, grade 3 Arrowsmith, they will be directed to a form. And so in the form, they can already type in their draft. So here, they type in their name, the title of their chosen story, and then we have the beginning, the middle, and the end. So this form is also shared in collaboration with the reading teacher. So the reading teacher can also grade this form, and she can see the drafts of the kids. So here, and I'm planning to also put here some prompt at the end of the form. I'm planning to post something about going back to the site because they need to go back and try to see if they have followed the rubrics. So here we have here the standards for grading. So there's a checklist rubrics that is child friendly. So it's very short. The kids, I think, can understand what this means. So for beginning, they'll have to see if the story tells when and where it happened, if it narrates who the main characters are, if the problem was exposed, and then we have the middle, and then the end, if the moral was revealed at the end of the story, and we have capitalization and punctuation. So the kids will have to go back to this checklist and try to polish their work. And then in the next meeting, they will be doing their final draft or their final story. So this is the interdisciplinary performance task page. We have here another page called the Holy Eucharist exhibit. So last year, since for the whole school year, the kids learned about the Holy Eucharist from the introductory rites to the concluding rites. The performance task that they did, the final performance task that they did, was to role play the Holy Eucharist since they could not do their first communion. So they tried to role play it by group. So each group was assigned a part in the Holy Mass, and they had to meet with their groupmates for practice and then for the final performance. And so here I chose some performances that I think that somehow showed the proper behavior during Mass, and we have here the performances that were really clear. So it starts with a welcome message. So welcome to the Holy Eucharist exhibit. And then here you can see the different parts of the Mass role played by various groups last school year. So these videos come from Microsoft Stream. So since I am part of the GC of these groups in grade 3, so I was able to access their videos, and here I am exhibiting their videos. So if I click on the play button, I don't know if you can hear it.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be.
Okay, let's stop at that. So that's just a sample. So the kids for this school year, for grade 3, they can actually see what their ates and kuyas did last school year. And they will get excited on the final performance task that they are going to do for CLF. So they will have an idea. Like we have here other groups that who really made an effort to really dress up as the priest. They made circular breads as host, and they really showed the right positions, the right behavior during the Holy Mass. So you can see the creativity of the kids and the resourcefulness. And we were not able to do the concluding rites because this was the last lesson, so we didn't have time anymore. So at the end of the SharePoint page, you could see here the scripts of the groups. So I added a file viewer, so as a web part, so the kids can actually see the scripts. They will just have to scroll down, and they can also download it, and they can appreciate the lessons that we will be talking about for this school year, since they already can see the whole picture. Okay, so why are we talking about the introductory rites or the liturgy of the word? Oh, these are the parts of the Mass. Okay, so this is the whole Mass. We're talking about the whole Mass for this school year. So this is the Holy Eucharist exhibit. So far, this is what I'm going to share with you for SharePoint. Now, let's try to go to Google site. So since my SharePoint site is almost full with the storage is almost full. So I tried to use another platform, which is Google site, so that I will have enough storage for my documents. So here we have the Magis Society Student Council. This is the Google site. So we start with the vision mission of the council. I just highlighted some words like renewed governance, communal discernment, and inspired decision-making, because these are some of the ways wherein the kids will be able to really use their talents, but at the same time, form an attitude of discernment and prayer in their leadership, in organizing and being part of the events. So we have here the upcoming activities, and beside it, we have the steps on communal discernment. So for example, we have upcoming event, which is the Buwan ng Wika. We have a virtual general assembly every month. So for Buwan ng Wika, these are the details, the date, the venue. And then there is this communal discernment steps. Okay, so we invite the kids to do a personal discernment. Okay, so now I am smuggling the, we have here the concept of discernment in the Magis Student Council. So start with personal discernment, because for the Magis Student Council, we invite volunteers. We do not force them to join, but we invite them, we encourage them to join. And so there are many kids who really want to volunteer, but they also need to do something for their academics. So they really have to discern. Am I keeping a balanced life? Can I volunteer and at the same time pass my performance tasks on time? So these are the things that they need to consider. And so before our monthly meeting for the Buwan ng Wika celebration, I've already gathered an idea of where they are, so their context. So we invite them to pray, and then we invite them to reflect on the task at hand. And so it says here, if you are ready, click on the idea button. So if they click on this, they will be directed to a Google form. So here we can see the leadership profile of the kids. So there are advisors in the different grade levels who assign beadles, they assign presidents, they assign responders. They call them pupil responders. So there are there is no definite leadership role for each section depending on the advisors. But for the Magis Student Council, we are rooting for volunteers. So we're really forming the spirit of volunteerism among the kids. So here we have here the concept of head work and heart work. So they are asked, how important is the upcoming event for you? Why do you say so? So the upcoming event is, for example, the Buwan ng Wika. So the kids will have to reflect on that. Oh, the Buwan ng Wika is important because this is a celebration of our Filipino culture, of our Filipino language. So they are asked to reflect, and then they are asked to share their head work, their heart work, and their hard work. So so these are the essentials for any event in Sacred Heart. So we have the morning offering. So who will say the morning offering? The prayer from the heart. Okay, will I volunteer to lead the prayer from the heart? Will I volunteer to lead the panunumpa? Or will I volunteer to be the MC? And do I have suggestions about the upcoming event? So just like last year, in grade 3, when we were having our practice with the Holy Eucharist role play, so I was just listening to the groups, and some of them really gave ideas and suggestions, and some of them really told each other, or there was this emerging leader who told the group, okay, we are going to change our virtual background. I will be sending you the virtual background, and you will all have to change your backgrounds. So they have these creative ideas, and they are very resourceful despite the limitations of online learning. So this form ends with a thank you note. So thank you for your participation. The results of this form will be discussed during the monthly meeting. So now we have here information about the context of the kids. And this becomes a stepping stone for collaboration. So This is the one of the some of the features of the Google site of the Student Council. And here you can also see the resources. So every month, we have this tradition of giving or allowing the kids facilitate the meeting with their classmates. So they are the ones who tell the agenda. So they're the ones who disseminate the information about monthly activities in school, about campaigns in school. So they invite their classmates to participate in the campaigns. They promote the campaigns. So they also help the school in all its promotion of the activities. So we provide them with resources so that they will not have to worry. Oh, what are we gonna do? Should we make a PowerPoint presentation? What are we gonna say? So they are also provided with a script and with all of these resources. So this is just the homepage of the Madge's Student Council Google site. So there's another page. We have here the events page. It contains the different activities of the Madge's Student Council. We have the upcoming events. We have the leadership training. And then we also have past events. So this will also serve as a gallery for those who want to know what the Madge's Student Council is all about. And at the last page, we have the About page. You can also see some information about servant leadership and about being a volunteer. So this is like our promotional page. So do you want to share your talents and skills with the school community? Click on the I Volunteer button to help in school events and campaigns. So if they click on this button, they will be directed to this one here. We have the I Volunteer Google form. So here they will be asked to self-reflect. So am I good in public speaking, in singing, in dancing, in writing? And then they will also be asked to ask permission from their parents. So they need a parent's consent. And then lastly, there's a note. Thank you for your spirit of volunteerism. Your desire to share your talents and skills with the whole school community is the first step towards service and leadership. So, and then there's also an instruction that feedback will be given through MS chat. Okay, so this is for the Madge Student Council. So lastly, this is the very last one. We have the Human Bingo. It's a very simple activity on Google site. And you can also do this on SharePoint site. So it says here, answer the questions in the Human Bingo by clicking on the Padlet link. So let me just click on the Padlet link. And we have here the questions. Okay, what is your name? They can copy paste the questions on Padlet and they can answer them on Padlet also. And the prerequisite, okay, for them to participate and to get the bingo, to get the prize for the Human Bingo activity, is for them to scavenge for names. They have to scavenge for names to write on their Human Bingo card. So they have to go to the Padlet link here, and they have to look for the names of their classmates. Okay, what is your favorite color? Okay, in the Human Bingo card, we have here favorite color. We have here a question. My favorite color is, let's say, I think this is the one. So his or her favorite color is blue. Okay, so I go back to Padlet. Okay, so let's say Joanna's favorite color is blue. So I'm going to write the name Joanna. Okay, Joanna. And then he or she is the eldest in the family. So we go back to Padlet again. Okay, who is the eldest here in among my classmates? So, oh, here's Mario. I'm going to write his name here. And then the last instruction says, type the word bingo in the chat box if you are done filling in all the blanks. So this becomes a platform for discussion also once they're done with the asynchronous activity, the human bingo activity. Okay, so I think this is the last one. So thank you so much for listening, and thank you for giving me a chance to share my experience and some insights on SharePoint and Google Sites. So I hope that we will be able to have a magic school year and a happy Ignatian year. So thank you very much.
All right, so thank you so much, Esteban. So now we will be opening up the floor for a short Q&A. So if you have any questions, kindly type them in the chat box below, or you're also free to unmute.
Hello, Ma'am Naomi. So specific sites when looking for Bible stories that are more child-friendly or Catholic-friendly. So there are actually sites we have here pages, I think, on YouTube, but some of the pages are not Catholic. No? So what I did, because these we have here, these videos that I used for my performance task 1.2, they all come from YouTube. So there is no particular page or YouTube page that I actually benchmark on, but then I just make sure that at the end of the video, there is no other, what you call this, religion. Because sometimes they would post the religion, if it's Catholic, if it's a Christian, if it's a Christian page. So I make sure that I watch all the videos before I download them. Thank you so much for that. Okay, did you include pictures of the Magis Student Council? Yes, actually there is at the end. There are pictures of the kids, but for now, since the volunteers usually come towards August or September, there are no pictures yet. But just to show you, let me go back again to the site. So these are just dummy pictures right here. So if we scroll down, there's actually a part that says meet your servant leaders. So the Magis Society Student Council accepts volunteers from grades 3 to 6 within the school year. So scroll down to meet these amazing people. So we have here the pictures supposed to be, and then their names, and their grade and section, and we have here their motto, their leadership motto. Okay, thank you so much for that suggestion. That's actually a very good suggestion, because sometimes they kids who don't know about the Magis Student Council, they want to know who are part, and once they get to see their faces, they will say, oh, I know that person. I want to be like him too. So this is also a form of promotion and advertisement for those who are who have the desire to serve the school through the Magis Student Council. Okay. There is yes, we have the Data Privacy Act also. We just need to make sure that the Google site is not for public use. So the kids should use their Google accounts to access the site. So, and they again, when they want to volunteer, they need to get a consent from their parents. So their parents will be given a form wherein they allow their kids to join, to participate in the activities of the Magi Student Council. Okay, which is better, SharePoint or Google Sites? For depending on the learning management system, so there are we have here schools who use the G Suite apps, and there are also those who use the SharePoint. We have here Microsoft Office 365. So for SharePoint, they actually allow links to be part of the web parts. So, and for Google Sites, it's also the same thing, but perhaps SharePoint, based on experience, SharePoint has more security because you really cannot access the site if you are not part of the organization. So, but for Google, once you have an account and the site is made public, then you can actually access it. So here, for example, this one is part of a Google site from a public school in the US. So this is their library, one of their libraries. They have a lot of libraries. So if you click on this, so you will be directed to the we have here to the book. And so the kids can actually read, they can read an ebook. There's also a similar feature about this kind of library, online library, in SharePoint. But then SharePoint uses Kindle. Okay, so I don't know if you can see the screen, but again, to answer the question, so SharePoint has more security and more security based on experience. So for Google, you can actually make it public. So depending on the permissions that you set on the settings, so just make sure that the permissions, the setting is exclusive to your organization, so that the data and the information will be protected. Okay, thank you so much.
So I think that would be all the time that we have for today. Thank you so much again, Ms. Tabon, and to all the participants who joined this session.